An international organization behind major credit card theft was uncovered today in Clinton with stolen information from folks not even in the state.
That's right. The investigation is still ongoing, involving several law enforcement and two federal agencies. And WJTV 12's Alex Love spoke with some of them today. He joins us live in our studio now with the latest details. Alex?
Yes, Melanie and Byron, working with your money digitally can be a risky action sometimes, but thankfully, one Clinton Bank's ATM machine caught these hackers in the act before possibly taking off with thousands of dollars and card numbers from residents.
We had an organization come through Clinton using clone debit cards. These cards got locked into the ATM machines when they were used, and we got a call from Regions Bank indicating that we had some clone cards.
Here's how it works. Using a small device known as a skimmer, criminals can rig an ATM machine keypad to steal a person's card and PIN number when you make a transaction. The machine then stores all your bank account info for identity thieves to make fake credit cards in your name and make purchases.
So they'll then take that information from the skimming device and re-encode a blank, maybe a gift card. So now they're armed with not only the cardholder's information, but as well as the PIN number. And they can go to an ATM or go to a grocery store, gas station, and use these cards.
Once discovering their ATMs locked up with these clone cards, Region Bank officials immediately contacted Clinton police, who later found out the group of hackers have been targeting more Region Banks across the nation.
The skimming devices were specific to Regions Bank ATMs. So that's kind of how we put that together. These gift cards had a decal on the back of them with the name Regions on them, as well as a four-digit PIN number.
Since discovering the fake credit cards, three men have been arrested in connection to this international organization, including 31-year-old George Zika, who is believed to be the man seen in the Clinton region surveillance photos inserting the fake debit card.
From that point, we take the cards to the police department. We have a scanner here in our office. We're able to get the magnetic data off that with the name, get back with the bank. They get us their cardholder information. We're able to reach out to these people and talk to them and ask them if they've been victim of credit card fraud. And if so, we're going to need a report because we got some charges on somebody.
And Clinton police told me as of now, no victims appear to be from the Clinton area, but authorities are still investigating and checking other ATMs and pumps just in case.